Dr. David Sinclair is a world-renowned Harvard Medical School scientist, one of Time's most influential people, a best-selling author of the book Lifespan, Why We Age and Why We Don't Have to, and leading authority on anti-aging research. Here's the complete longevity protocol that he follows in hopes of living well north of 120 years. In the morning, he takes...
I take a gram, 1,000 milligrams of NMN every day.
NMN, or nicotinamide mononucleotide, is a molecule that helps increase NAD plus levels inside our bodies. Boosting NAD plus levels, which naturally decline with aging, increases energy production and cellular repair. NMN supplements have been shown to reduce tissue inflammation and improve insulin secretion and insulin action, mitochondrial function, and function of neurons in the brain.
Taking resveratrol at a gram a day.
David takes resveratrol with yogurt to improve cardiovascular health and memory and reduce inflammation levels. 500 milligrams of quercetin and 500 milligrams of fisetin with yogurt to reduce levels of senescent cells. Senescent cells are cells that accumulate with aging and can drive inflammation and aging. He takes 1 milligram of spermidine to reduce the risk of age-related diseases like heart disease, neurodegeneration, metabolic disease, and cancer.
I'm taking C60,
yes,
and so far so good.
David recently started taking C60 or carbon-60, an antioxidant that may slow aging. According to his book Lifespan, David takes these supplements during the day: alpha-lipoic acid to reduce blood sugar levels and free radicals. David doesn't specify his dose, but most guidelines recommend 300 to 1200 milligrams per day. 81 milligrams of aspirin, also known as baby aspirin, to lower the risk of heart attack and stroke. Coenzyme Q10 to lower blood sugar levels and the risk of age-related diseases. Again, David doesn't specify his dose, but most guidelines recommend 100 to 200 milligrams per day. He also takes an unknown dose of statin to reduce cholesterol levels, since David has a family history of cardiovascular disease. 2,000 international units of vitamin D3 to boost bone growth and lower inflammation and age-related diseases. Vitamin K2 to prevent heart-related diseases and promote blood coagulation in brain, bone, and skin health. Here again, David doesn't specify his dose, but other experts like Dr. Rhonda Patrick take 15 micrograms of vitamin K2, the MK7 subtype. In the evenings, David takes...
I was talking about metformin.
Yeah.
1 gram a day for me.
Metformin is a prescription drug that can lower fat, insulin, leptin, and cholesterol levels. Metformin may also extend lifespan in humans, with one study showing non-diabetics taking metformin lived 15% longer compared to the general population. Of note, he doesn't take metformin before exercising, since there's some evidence that metformin blocks some benefits of exercise. He also takes it with food to minimize nausea. David has also started to supplement with berberine, a plant-derived compound with similar properties to metformin. Although the dose he takes is not clear, most guidelines recommend 500 milligrams 1 to 3 times per day before meals. David also takes omega-369 fish oil to lower inflammation and help fend off heart attack, stroke, arthritis, and cancer. David doesn't specify his dose, but other experts like Dr. Peter Attia recommend taking 2 to 3 grams of omega-3s with high levels of EPA. It's important to note that David sometimes breaks from taking supplements for a day to give his body, especially his liver, a rest. David's diet follows a motto that he believes is the number one thing we can do to extend healthy lifespans: eat less often. To achieve this, he practices intermittent fasting by skipping breakfast and lunch, meaning that he essentially follows OMAD, or one meal a day. But since his one meal sometimes consists of grazing on food in the evening, he technically follows a 23-to-1 or 20-to-4 time-restricted eating diet because he consumes his meals during 1-to-4-hour windows. If he's not grazing, he has one large meal in the evenings, which is typically low in carbohydrates and plant-based. For instance, a large salad with a variety of bright colored vegetables, cheese, nuts, dark chocolate, and some fruit. But he admits that he is a struggling vegan because he occasionally consumes seafood and chicken. David does sometimes have an alcoholic drink in the evening, either red wine or whiskey. He doesn't count calories, but estimates that he eats half the amount that his peers do for dinner. David understands that exercise is beneficial for health, vitality, preventing disease, and slowing progression of disease. David's routines include strength and aerobic training 3 to 5 times per week, totaling 30 to 60 minutes per day. For strength training, David lifts weights every day to every other day up to 3 times per day. He weight trains in the gym typically once per day, focusing on exercises that build strength in his legs, back, core, and hips. When he's sitting at his desk, he uses lighter weights and does many quick repetitions to also gain aerobic benefits. To build cardiovascular health and endurance, he does high-intensity aerobic exercises that make him increase his breathing and heart rate, such as running or cycling, for at least 10 minutes, 2 to 3 times per week. Between these exercise sessions, he makes sure he's not inactive for long periods of time, such as prolonged sitting. He does this by using a standing desk and moving often, using an under-desk pedal bike or getting up for a brisk walk. David knows that sleep is essential for health and longevity, but because of his schedule, he occasionally has non-optimal sleeping habits, such as going to bed late and only getting 5 to 6 hours of sleep at night. But he started a routine to improve the quality and length of his sleep. He tries to be calm before going to bed by meditating, reading, or taking a warm shower. He avoids screen time, but if needed, he wears blue light blocking glasses. He uses 8 Sleep, a mattress that lowers the temperature of his bed. On top of it all, David follows mindfulness practices to improve his health, especially decrease stress levels, keep his immune system primed, and improve mental health.
The one thing that helps me is combining the breath work with meditation.
He often meditates, aiming for 15 minutes before sleeping, and he also does breath work, such as box breathing. David also likes to practice cold and hot therapy to improve his health, which mimic adversity on the body. For cold therapy, he mostly sleeps with very few covers on his bed to lower his body temperature. He also occasionally uses a sauna and ice baths. Plus, he said he sometimes uses a hyperbaric oxygen chamber to increase the amount of oxygen his blood carries. David Sinclair uses wearable technology to give him quick and continuous feedback about his daily health. He says this of wearables: you need a dashboard for your body the same way you need a dashboard for your car. David uses the Freestyle Libre continuous glucose monitor to track his blood glucose levels, which helped him figure out which foods spiked his blood glucose and therefore avoid, and when his blood glucose levels naturally oscillate throughout the day. He also uses Insight Tracker to measure blood-based biomarkers, including HbA1c, free cholesterol, low and high density lipoproteins, and triglycerides. He uses the Aura Ring to measure his sleep quantity and quality, health parameters, and movement. He uses the BioButton, a medical-grade wearable device that continuously monitors multiple vital signs, including skin temperature, resting respiratory rate, resting heart rate, activity levels, and sleep. And he uses an Apple Watch to track his exercise and activity levels. If you want to know what longevity therapies David is likely to try next, check out these videos.